Hi, I'm Carrie Fairneck with Convention News Television. This is SGMP TV. Attendees here at NEC were energized by the keynote speech by Simon Bailey, and the man of the hour is right behind me signing books and autographs. He's really connecting with each person here, which is key, and all of us will remember that Simon says to be brilliant.
How do I buy the future? And you buy the future when you decide to own the moment.
Bailey reminded all of us to tap into our brilliancy by owning the moment. We can do that by being present and connecting with people instead of just communicating. I had a chance to catch up with Simon after his presentation. I'm joined now by Simon Bailey, and what an incredible presentation. Standing ovation, by the way.
I think it's because I had a good hair day. It's a good hair day for me.
What do you hope people take away?
I want people to really take away that in this economy, they have the ability to own the moment, create the future, and make it happen. We are in a connection economy, and people have to think about how do you stop communicating and start connecting with your meeting attendees, with your participants, so that they just don't hear, but they learn. They just don't tell, but they ask, and they just don't get, but they also learn how to give.
So inspiring and so funny. I'm still kind of feeling awkward. My bracelet and watch on the wrong hands. What a great moment and a great way to remember it.
Awesome. Because you know what? You've always been doing it the other way. You've always worn your watch or piece of jewelry on the opposite wrist. Flip it. Undo it. Do something else. Just don't settle for the status quo. And what happens is once you do something different, you'll discover something that was always there, but you never saw it.
Fantastic. Well, you are brilliant.
Thank you.
We had a chance to catch up with some other brilliant folks to find out what they thought of your presentation.
Oh my goodness, I absolutely loved him. I am a fan of anything that's personal growth and development. And I love the idea that I'm able to take something back and help my organization.
God, I realized that I am really brilliant. I am brilliant. It was awesome. I enjoyed him so much.
I thought it was incredible. I really enjoyed it, and I've taken away a lot from it. I think he came at a pretty unique time with some questions that I've been considering as well. So I thought it was brilliant.
Simon never disappoints, ever. I think this is about the sixth or seventh time I've seen him, and he's fabulous. I love that he keeps reminding me that I'm brilliant, because everybody in my life doesn't tell me that, so he's fantastic.
We will all remember to own the moment for a long time to come. And now I'd like to toss things over to my brilliant colleague, Sarah Solomon, who's on the other side of the expo hall. Sarah?
Thanks, Carrie. Now, there's a positive energy here at NEC, and the meeting planners that we talked to said that even though they're facing some tough challenges, they're working through it by sticking together.
A lot of the planners have been in similar situations with me, especially now when we really have to watch our budgets. So they've been giving me really good ideas, like the when you're doing food and beverage, to do chef's choice. Because that way you don't have to worry about picking your meals. It tends to be a less expensive way to have your food and beverage.
Being able to talk to or network with some of the other suppliers and planners, it gives you a lot of ideas as to things you can do. And then you always have someone you can call and ask information, so they've been very helpful. And you learn so much from being here, attending the classes, but you also learn a lot when you're standing out networking with people.
Everybody's been so friendly and welcoming. I really appreciate that very much. I don't feel like there isn't anybody that I couldn't talk to or connect with if I had a dumb question. I feel like anybody would be happy to answer it.
As you can see, Carrie, there's really a sense of unity within the SGMP community. Planners are not only exchanging best practices while they're here at NEC, but they plan to do so following the conference. Back to you.
Thanks, Sarah. That was also the message to chapter presidents and second vice presidents during their meeting here in Orlando.
And it's imperative that you empower people to do things. If you can't turn...
The leaders were encouraged to be the energy outlets for their team, which will empower and leverage people to get involved within the association. The goal is working together to build a better business.
Any organization needs to have someone that's plugging in, that's driving the energy shift. You know, I think a lot of people, their home life is hard, work is hard, and they come to these conferences and stuff, and they want to be a part of something that's exciting for them. And that usually takes one person or a small group of people who can really excite that energy level in people to get them out of their box and make them feel good, refreshed, refueled, and re-energized about what they do.
Meeting professionals were reminded to disprove negative movement towards associations by sharing personal stories to emotionally charge others into joining.
I think associations really kind of strengthen
strengthen who you are as a professional. It's a time where you can bond with other people who live a similar life to you, have similar experiences, even though you might not work for the same direct agency. And so I think people really need to see that it's a strengthening tool and it's a good investment because it's that person-to-person networking that you might not get on your daily job when you're in the daily grind of it.
That'll do it for this edition of SGMP TV. I'm Carrie Farinak with Convention News Television. But before we go, back by popular demand, one more look at the SGMP flash mob that has everybody talking.